So I'm trying to do a video in the car, which is crazy. I just wanted to experiment with being able to film it and then upload it from my phone. But anyway, I wanted to make a quick video. I've been reading this book called Giving Them Grace, Dazzling Your Children with the Love of Jesus, and it has been awesome. It's been very challenging and just encouraging and really good. Basically, the main message in it can be very overwhelming and very weighty, so if you do go and read it, just take it, approach it with, cool, this is great stuff, but the authors don't intend, and there is no need for every single conversation that you have with your child to look in the ways modeled. But we do need to take advantage and to make opportunities as often as possible to share the gospel with our children. But the basic idea is, how is your parenting as a Christian different from the world's parenting or any other people's parenting? All parents, if they're responsible, are going to teach their children obedience and manners and social laws and, you know, saying please, thank you, all that stuff. So that's just a secular, a worldly person may do that. So that's not what should set your children apart, the fact that they obey so well. What should set your parenting and your children apart is that they hear the gospel every single day, and that you take situations and use them to share the gospel. So if my children are being unloving to each other, unkind to one another, and I tell them, you know, you need to change your attitude, and the response is, I can't, perfect opportunity to say, you're right, buddy, you can't. You cannot change your attitude. Only God can change your attitude. And so let's pray right now and ask God to help you change your attitude. And then you just remind them, we can't do anything of our own strength. Only God can help us be good. Only God can help us be loving and kind. So we need to pray for a new heart and remember that Jesus came and died for our sins, and he forgives us. And if we believe in him, he will save us. He'll give us new hearts. And that's an opportunity right there. And they don't happen just like that all the time, but us as Christian parents with Christian parenting should be making those opportunities as often as possible. And I mean, some of the stuff that we discussed in my group, because it can become so overwhelming every time you start addressing your children, you're like, I need to approach them with the gospel. It's not going to happen. It's impossible to do it every single time, and that's fine. That's not the message. But even if you just share the gospel at least once a day with your child, that's 365 times a year that they're hearing the gospel. And I mean, think about how many times in their life as the years go on. So once a day is even, once every other day is even a significant amount of time. And the Lord is the changer of hearts, not us. We just need to take our parenting as what it is, a role, a responsibility given to us from God, and use it and do it unto the Lord. And we need to remember that our children are a ministry, and just because we're at home, not overseas sharing the gospel with a lost people group, we are at home with lost children who need the gospel just as much as every other lost person on this planet, and they are our mission field, and we need to take that seriously. And as weighty as it actually is, their souls are in need of salvation, and we have the tools and the truth to bring that to them, because God is so gracious. He has given us eternal life and given us the knowledge that we need to be saved, and now we need to teach our children and pray that they will teach their children, and that their children will teach their children, and that it will just go on and on. That's our daily prayer, that the Lord would save them at an early age, and that this would be the break of the chain in our family tree, and that all the people in our family after this will just know and love Christ. So I hope this is encouraging to you. Christian parenting should be set apart from just, you know, all other parents. Our children need to hear the gospel, and we need to present it to them daily and not tell them that they are good, but tell them that they cannot be good without Jesus, and that they need a new heart from Jesus. And that's it. Thank you.